Hello guys and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this class we are discussing about the identifiers, keywords, control characters, implicit and explicit line joining method. First we'll see what are identifiers. Identifiers are nothing but these are the names which are used in our program. For example, variable name, function name, etc. Identifiers can contain letter, digits and underscores. The first letter of the identifier should be a letter or underscore. It should not be start with digit. Okay, now we'll see few example for identifiers. As I said, variable name is an example for identifier, right? So I'll create one variable here. And I'll assign some value. And it is a valid variable name. As I said, the first letter of the variable name can be underscore also. It's also valid. If we take first letter of the variable is digit, then because the first letter of the variable name is digit, so it will give syntax error. As I said, variable name can include letter, digit and underscore. Special characters are excluded in the identifier. For example, if you use any special character in the variable name, then it will give error. Okay, this is about the identifiers. Now we'll move to the keywords. Keywords are nothing but these are the words which has predefined meaning. For example, and, or, else, these are called as keywords. We can't use keywords as identifiers. If we try to use keywords as identifier, then it will give error. For example, AND is a keyword. I'll try to assign some value to AND, then it will give syntax error. If you want to know more about the keywords, then just type help and within the single quote type keywords and we can see the list of Python keywords. Okay, this is about the keywords. Next, control characters are the character which will control the output. For example, here if you want welcome to Amul's Academy to print in the next line, then you can use slash n here. It is a control character which is used for new line. And now we can say hello and welcome to Amul's Academy in two different lines. Then implicit and explicit line joining method. When we try to divide the input into different physical lines, then it will give error. For example, now I want to write the rest of the words in next line. So I'll press enter. It will give syntax error. It can be overcome by using implicit and explicit line joining method. First we'll see implicit line joining method. The rule of the implicit line joining method is, in the single line, the number of the open quotes should be equal to the closed quotes. For example, now if I press enter, then it will give error. If you apply implicit line joining method, according to that, here the number of open quotes is 1, so I'll close that. Now if I press enter, I can type the rest of the words here. And we can see the output, right? Then next is explicit line joining method. In this method we are using backward slash to split the input. Now I'll use backward slash. And we can see the output. Okay, this is about the few fundamental concepts in Python programming language. That's it for now. Thank you for watching. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.